The topic today we are going to discuss is communication skills. So, most of the times people think that communication skills is language. Sometimes people tell that if I know English, I will have effective communication skills. Some people think that if I know Telugu better, I can be an effective communicator. The communication skills are entirely different from language. In fact, you know, the communication is what you would like to share to other person, what the other person understands. So, in a nutshell, I would like to share that what you communicate and the other person does not understand exactly what you communicate, then there is no communication skill. Let me share one simple example. A small daughter goes to the mother and asks for, "Mommy, mommy, why don't you make some roundies for me?" The mommy understands, "Okay, I will do it tomorrow, but not today," and tomorrow she will make. And what is that round is that lady is asking, or the daughter is asking to the mother, is jangri. But see, the girl may not be knowing, or the baby may not be knowing, that the name of that sweet is jangri, but she communicates to the mother stating that I need that roundies which are in round or circle something. So, here exactly if you think that the vocabulary that she shared and the mother understood is entirely different. Now, here do you think that without using jangri, the daughter understood and mother understood? Now, what we come to know from this is that the vocabulary does not matter what you speak, and the vocabulary content matters. Imagine for a moment, when I am talking to the people, if I am not using a simple language, if I am not getting connected to the people, if they do not understand my language, I am sure that I am not an effective communicator. I do not know how many of you face this kind of situation. You tell something, the other person understands something. Sometimes, most of the times, rather than understanding, you misunderstand. Why it happens? We find discussions, people say that, "What did I say wrong? No, I said, no, I did not mean it." No, no, you mean it. What happens? Why all these things happen? Because of non-congruence of the verbal and non-verbal skills. Now, let me come to the point. Do we communicate more with verbal skills or non-verbal skills? Definitely, we communicate more with non-verbal skills than verbal skills. Let me share one more important point. The communication happens even before you speak. If you do not speak, also communication happens. Gestures communicate a lot. Let me share you an example. If you look at a girl and say that like this, what do you mean by that? You are beautiful. Did I use the word beautiful anywhere? No. So, the gesture which I am telling is very important. So, sometimes people say that there is a gesture like this. This is for victory. So, before you communicate to the people, the gestures communicate. I am sure that you are trying to understand the body language is very important. Verbal skills and non-verbal skills both are very important. So, you need to focus more on non-verbal skills. That is the reason most of the times 93% of the communication happens through your body language, not with your verbal skills. So, you need to focus more on verbal skills. Let me give an example. If you talk about the hairstyle of a person, when you are talking to the people about the hairstyle, don't you think that different people have got different kinds of hairstyles? What exactly do you think about the hairstyle? People say that this is a new trend, we are setting the new trend. What kind of trend are you setting? People want everybody to get their attention. But if I show you, imagine for a moment, there is a person or there is a doctor who has got spikes. Can you expect patients to go and talk to the doctor or take treatment from the doctor? He may be an expert in his area, but still the spikes does not make you to imagine him as a doctor. You have your own imagination about a doctor. There is a professionalism that you need to follow whenever you are going to talk to the person how professional he is. So, now first point which I would like to emphasize is, number one is verbal skill, second one is non-verbal skills. And I would like to say that non-verbal skills are more important than verbal skills. Now, let us discuss one after the other. What are those verbal skills? Verbal skills, vocabulary, sentences and words. When it comes to non-verbal skills, let me talk something about facial expressions. How many of you got an experience when you look at a person, you say that, hey, why are you dull today? Something wrong with you. Now, why you ask him? Does he have any board on his body that I am not well, please ask me? No. By seeing the facial expression of the person, you will talk to him, something wrong, because he is dull. The expression is visible on his face. So, this facial expression is a non-verbal skill which you are going to get connected and you understand. You know that most of the times when you smile, that shows your happiness. And for a moment you look at a person and you give a smile, what does it mean? You are ready to help him or you are ready to talk to him. Imagine for a moment you look at the person, you look serious. What does it mean that you don't like to talk to that person? Frowning faces are not very much content oriented and they don't like to talk to those people. So, facial expressions play a prominent role. I am sure still today in Indian context, we say that eye contact is missing. But if you don't have an eye contact, you cannot understand what the other person is speaking. Eye contact plays a prominent role. I am seeing, if you take your own experiences, imagine for a moment when you are talking to anyone. If I seeing their expressions, you may change the contextual words. That's the reason most of the times if you want to talk to the important things, relationship management, speak face to face. Written communication may not always help you how to have a better relationship. Whereas, when you talk about the expressions and when you talk to them, you are knowing their emotional background also. I hope that you understand emotions do communicate. Happy emotion, sad emotion, and what kind of anger. These things are visible on the face. So, facial expressions are very important. Imagine for a moment I don't use the gestures. I keep my hand like this. No facial expression, look seriously and say that, my dear friends, communication skills are very important. If you don't have the communication skills, you will not going to have a better relationship. Learn communication skills. Communication skills are verbal skills, non-verbal skills. If I say like this, are you interested in knowing and listening to me? No. So, facial expressions and also the gestures are very important. When I say, I am talking about the first point, the moment I say first point, that speaks. Sometimes the perception does matter. I have seen somewhere an example, one person showing the hands, how many fingers are there in this hand? One person said 2, one person said 3, one person said 5. I say all of them are correct, because when I spoke, I did not ask the right question with clarity. Clarity is very important when you communicate to the people. When I say how many fingers are open means I can say 2. If I say how many fingers are there, 5 is correct, 2 is correct and 3 is correct. Unless otherwise you have clarity in asking, you cannot be. I am sure that whenever you see, look at the person through his facial expression and body language, whether he is very confident or not. So, most of the times when you attend an interview or when you go for any appointment, when you talk to the people, your body language tells that, are you a confident guy or you have self-inferiority complex or are you okay? So, that is the reason whenever when you communicate to the people, you need to understand all these things. The most important thing in the communication is that you should have, what am I speaking? With whom am I speaking? Why am I speaking? If you don't know what you are speaking and why you are speaking, if you don't know the purpose of speaking or communication, I am sure that every purpose of communication is to share information, knowledge, or train, or else get things done. Especially when you are talking to the people, you don't find enough time. Imagine if you are talking to your friend, you can talk to hours together, but when you go to the officials, when you want to talk to a collector, he may give 10 minutes or 15 minutes. If you want to go and meet a minister, he may give 5 minutes. If you go to a higher level, they may give you very less time. But how effectively you can convince them and you can communicate to them is very important than how much time are you speaking. So, based upon your purpose, you need to speak. what you need to speak, how you need to speak, where you need to speak is very important. I am sure that I have thrown certain ideas about what communication skills is that. Let me wrap up with the gist. Number one, communication is the lifeline for everyone. If you want to be happy, it is the communication skill which decides to be happy or unhappy, number one. Second thing is that we have two, verbal and non-verbal skills. Verbal skills, I have already told that sentences, and non-verbal skills, gestures, facial expressions, the way you stand, the posture, eye contact and facial expressions. And I am sure you try to put these efforts every day consciously and make your life happy. Use effective communication skills, be success in your life. All the best. Thank you.
ఈ వీడియో మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని అప్డేట్స్ కోసం మన ఛానల్ ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసి కింద కనిపిస్తున్న బెల్ బటన్ ని క్లిక్ చేయండి.